4.7.
I won't give him 5. Who has been to the Northern Territory Museum in Darwin and seen Cooinda? That's 5.1. You need to go to the Darwin Museum, some of you. Oh, two blokes have been here. Yeah, two blokes went there. Good on you. You used to tear them apart, folks. So that's how... Oh, God, he was a hardcore crook. Any crook that grabs a boat motor and tears it apart, and not the person, is just that. Well, lumps and the bumps. What's he doing? He's regulating his body temperature. They've got to keep their body at the 33-degree mark to digest the food that sits within their stomach. You see that back on that crocodile? It's actually a solar panel. Any bird that can take out 700 stinging insects a day for me, I want one on my shoulder, folks.
I'm the crocodile. There is no bigger, there is no more aggressive or most widely distributed than these saltwater crocodiles, folks. They are the boss of all of the crocodiles. She looks at you with beautiful green eyes because she's nocturnal. She's got binocular vision. They can see a lot better at night rather than the day because the day sight is absolutely shocking. They can hear everything that I say because directly behind their eyes, they got small cuts either side, which are the ears. They can hear you because they're called creatures. Sitting there with that mat there, you can see the tongue now. See that tongue, folks. You can see the teeth that continuously replace for about 40 or 50 years. Right, and I'll get this on the right, and then we're going to take off up that river that's in there, folks. Now, when we go up the river, folks, it's going to change from this look here, because the trees are going to get huge, to the point where you can't see the floodplains, basically. And up 2.4 billion years, we've had a lot of stuff, folks. No cat, another one jumping up. Meow, meow. What's that? That's the noise they make. You're kidding, Ruben, it sounds like a lake. Love it.